come in with a little bit of apple red base coat. We're just gonna do the lens on the mask, both the lenses here, and then a few cuts below those lenses. So we'll just kind of, I've masked this off with an inch and a half 3M green. So I think this will really make that section pop out. And like we talked about last time, when you use white down first, any color you tend to put on top of that's really going to pop out, whether it's urethane candy or some kind of a base coat color. This is once again base coat from House Colors, reduced 1:1 with reducer. Kind of up to you how much detail you want to put in to your stencil work. You can really go crazy with it, or we could have just laid this down white and done a green candy over it, and left it at that. I wanted to do a little bit of color work on this. Just to see what happens. You can always use the error function, just the trigger down, just use the error function to help speed up the drying process. Flash that solvent out of there a little faster. And we talked about doing some border work, or doing a little bit of, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fog some white down in here. I'm going to pull this tape up, and we'll use a little bit of material to make almost like a smoking effect coming off of it. And we'll get right to that. Okay, what we'll do now is a little bit of that border under here with a little bit of 3M pad, and we'll just start doing a little bit with white, and then we'll come in with the candy green under here, so we'll have a kind of a nice effect. What I'm doing, I'm just gonna fog it in a little bit. Getting a little spit out of the tip. Kind of creating a fog look underneath the mask. And once I hit that with the green, it's going to kind of look smoky. Now there's all sorts of materials you could use for it. I kind of like the look that this gives you. Kind of gives you that hazy, smoky look. Maybe even kind of, you could use this for clouds too, if you wanted to. And we'll come up along the side here too. Of course, the more white you lay down, the more prominent it's going to be. When you cover it with candy, like a transparent candy, that's really going to pop out at you. So the brighter it is, you know, the more white you lay down, I guess what I'm trying to say is the brighter it's going to pop out of that candy. I don't know what other colors. If I put green on now, I could just do green over it right now. It would look pretty neat. The whole mask would light up green. And then you'd have, of course, all that kind of fogging look under that green. Anything that's black. At this point, there's quite a bit of overspray over it. Anything that's black is going to stay black. If it was true black under there and I was real careful and kept it nice and clean, and you shot a candy over that right now, the black wouldn't show. Only the whites, or, you know, black has no reflection of light to it. Once you hit candy over it, there's nothing working underneath that candy. If it's just black, it's just gonna be black. Nothing's gonna show. So theoretically, I could just hit that right now with a green candy. I don't know if I want to hit some purples in there. I've got some purple base coat, but purple might look pretty good up at the top in the smoke area. And then green underneath, or purple underneath and green up top. I'm not sure. I'm just kind of thinking out loud right now. What would look best? Maybe some purple trails coming off of the majority of green. I don't know. I hope you guys are picking something up or getting ideas or something. That's the only reason I'm really doing this, is kind of practice myself, plus kind of entertain you guys or give you some ideas or something. So, okay.